I think I've started. I'm back. And I'm happy to see everybody there. I can't see y'all, but you can see me. Hopefully, the 2 weeks I took off have not affected your life very much. I appreciate everybody that I got to meet. For those that don't know, I was, in case it's going live right now, I'm back. I took 2 weeks off to help with the conference. If you didn't know, many of you know this, and many of you I met that are out there. I had a conference 2 weeks ago, April 6th and 7th, huge dental lab conference here in the state of Texas. Dental and ortho had a huge turnout. Got to meet many of you that are out there. It was great to meet y'all, run into y'all, and discuss products and stuff with y'all. But, man, I got to meet people from California, all ortho lab technicians from California and Florida, Massachusetts, Canada, Australia. I mean, we had everybody coming from everywhere. And I live streamed some of that, so you might have caught some of those. So hopefully that made up for the 2 weeks I took off where I didn't live stream. But I'm back, and I do have a little bit of a case here. I'm going to do like a bonded lingual, preformed bonded lingual. Shouldn't take too long. Hopefully I'm not that rusty. But anyway, I hope to see y'all. I'm glad to see y'all are tuning in again. I had a great time. I took last week off. I just need to recover and sleep. And it was very, heartwarming to see everybody there. And just to let y'all know, I actually live streamed a lot of the conference. Now I did a lot. I was actually paid to live stream the Crown and Bridge part, and that, from what I've heard, that worked out flawlessly. This thing has gone to sleep on me, but yeah, that went flawlessly. I'll show a little video of that. I'll do a little recap of everything. I live streamed the three of the ortho classes. One was Priscilla Meyer's hands-on, JBC's, Priscilla Meyer of JBC and Company, her hands, acrylic hands-on, also streamed the first ever meeting of the Association of Orthodontic Laboratory Professionals, which was very cool to be a part of, that first inaugural meeting. And then I live streamed the Lampert Puck D3. Now, I've taken the first two offline. I'll show a little preview of it here, but I want to clean them up. I want to condense them down, make them run a lot smoother. It was like a spur of the moment live stream, so I didn't have it set up the way I wanted. So I'm going to try to take the best parts of it and condense it down. And then, of course, that was Priscilla's hands-on. I really want to condense that down, make a really nice video, because it's very educational. And then the next one was the Association of Orthodontic Laboratory Professionals, and I needed to take some sensitive material out of that as a request of the new president, Christopher Jajewski, and so we're going to edit that down so everybody can see the progress on it. So without further ado, let me show you the hands-on. So this is Priscilla. If you see yourself in the background, say hello.
Earlier of mixing my colors, on the zebra I mixed black monomer with black powder. Reason, because black is a little bit of a different beast. That it just seems to work a little better. It's more plastic.
Say hi. This is Tina.
Colorado. Colorado in the house.
She used to watch my channel back when I was good.
I still do.
Yeah.
You're
informative.
That's good. A little bit.
No,
Yeah, me too.
Like tie dye and stuff like that if you want to bleed it. You know, just carve it in almost.
Yeah. Night guard.
Pours really well.
Yep.
How do you do one of these? Like marbling?
Yeah.
I mean, I can, but you do it really nicely.
Do you use that wire or something to pull your colors?
I will pull them through
bought like into a law class or something like that.
So, you can see she's going over the techniques. I'm going to fast forward a little bit. This is an hour and 46 minutes long. So I got a little hands on. Let me back that up. This is her famous zebra. And she does a layer of white, and then she mixes. Actually, I had my son switching cameras for me. I think at this time, I don't know. But she switched the cameras. Everybody was taking videos of it, and I'm sure everybody picked up something from this. Anyway, so this is just a preview of her doing. She did many. It was like a request line. She's like, "What do you want to do next?"
Where's that white?
Someone yell out polka dots, and so we would do polka dots. So she would sit there and just show how she did all these appliance designs in one step, very easily. So look,
I know a bakery shop that can use your help.
Some of these, I'm going to edit this down, make it a lot cleaner, nicer, take out some of the non-essential stuff in there. So anyway, that was Colored Acrylics Made Easy. Here is...
Oh, that's up.
Here is the meeting. Again, it's a spur of the moment kind of didn't have the camera set up right, didn't have the mic set up right. You can see my son. There I am. You can see my son. He's about to help do camera switching for us.
So I've been hearing about that. Welcome to the...
I'm extremely passionate about this.
I put in a lot of time and effort into it.
This was our meeting.
Literally a few miles away.
And
both times I lost a lot of my money.
Lots of engagement on this. It was really great.
A lawyer one retained, or that's covered by
a lot of people. So keep an eye out for the association.
But back to the lawsuit, because I know that there's a lot of people that are interested in, and know I'm hearing about that. The first thing that I need to say is that the cease and desist, it's bull crap. It's just as simple as that. They're just trying to position themselves for a market.
Here is the MicroPulse welder. This is live. You can watch this right now.
Everything that's included, or everything you need is included.
So
it also changed the
shots of the work, and so hopefully it turned out. I think it turned out okay. I could have done a little bit better job, but this is Gerard from Inman Ortho Lab. He's demonstrating the Puck D3 welder, so be sure and watch this video. And I put a link in there to the Lampert website where you can buy one of these. It's a $5,000 MicroPulse welder.
Faces or gaps
that you can't fill in with solder later. It's all going to be touching together.
I mean, you can go back and add fuller wire to it, but, you know, that just adds extra time. And I think the whole idea is to save time. You know, you don't want to add extra time by going back and filling all the little gaps.
There to there.
Yeah.
So, you know, we'll do that.
Oh, yeah. That's a good picture.
From there to there.
Yeah.
So, you know, we'll do that. And then we'll just go and we'll check it on the inside as well.
I just want to let you know it's there and keep an eye out for those other two. Hopefully they make up for not live streaming for the last 2 weeks. I saw I did three of those. Actually, I promised I'd show you a little bit of... the colored acrylics.
Decorate cakes.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah,
there's a lot of great conversation going on. That I
was never going to hear on the paper. I need to shrink it down to where it is.
Oh, yeah.
I tried it. I
Oh, what is she doing? What is she using, though? What are you using?
So there's spider web. And then, see if I can find it. My 12-year-old son tried his hand.
Our method of curing is above water, not submerged. So you skip the step of soaking.
Yeah. Practice your own.
I'll teach you a few things, and if you show your dad that,
I will give him a raise. We had a great time. So on the right is Priscilla, and then on the left is, I believe this is Drew. Yeah, from Canada. He was doing his polka dots. So we were all, I had filmed some of the people trying different things. Look at that retainer. That's amazing. So again, I'll have this edited down to where it's nicer and easier to do. Easier to watch. Oh, there's my son trying his hand at doing acrylics. And somebody was coming back behind him and showing him how to do some of this. Some of the guys there. I was getting free training from all the people there. It was great.
What color do you want?
You win.
It's all in the hand. You got to shake your hand.
Again, I had a great time there. Hopefully, I can edit these videos where you can get just a piece of what went on there, and that way you don't miss it next year. So, look for it next year, 2019, probably first week of April. Again, same location, Grapevine, Texas, Hilton DFW. So, hope to see y'all there. Meet more of you that are out there that actually watch my videos. So, I will show you one more thing, and I'm going to try to do this more. Get on the right page here. I did a lot of live streaming. The actual courses. So I'm hoping to do a lot more of these. There we go. So people were able to log in and watch. Sorry, I have to log in. Sorry, kind of boring right now for pages to load. I would show some pictures, but there was a fun karaoke night. I'm not supposed to show pictures from that. A lot of people asked me not to, but it was fun. Y'all missed out a lot if y'all weren't there, but the ones that were there know exactly what I was talking about. So these are the live streams I did for the Crown and Bridge. Using the same system, I'm going to do a video on my live streaming setup. Many of you have been asking me about that. So I'm just kind of showing you what all I was able to do this weekend, this past weekend. So this is...
Good morning.
Again, I would like to have a better setup next time.
Hey, welcome everybody to the 2018 Southwest Conference and Expo.
It doesn't work in my lab anymore, but it's all about the technique and the rest of the equipment, like the lens, the lights, the
sound.
About those buttons, because I don't use much of those buttons. Only buttons that I use is that mode button.
Anyway, it doesn't
and I
sound like
to
this.
Keep
it's
it in ETTL.
Live streaming setup, but,
and then the plus and the
minus. This just kind of shows you to. Clinic, and so I'm going to try to do more of these.
And that's the,
that
I mean,
you
yeah,
tune in from wherever you are
it's
in the world
not as good as DSLR, but.
But let's get back to the live stream. So you can disregard all that in front if you're not interested. I just thought it was fun to do, to show you what all went on that weekend and the fun times we had. All right, so for some reason, oh, there's not a. SD card in there. That is why it is not. There we go. So this is a bonded lingual using a preform wire. This is what this doctor wants. So I'm going to try to do this as quickly as possible so I don't take up too much else time. So I usually try to draw. So there's going to be two pads on each canine that are going to get drawn on there. And then I like to draw a line right above that cingulum. Each tooth, it's like a little shelf, and you want to lay your wire right in that shelf. So, there we go. So that's what we're going to make. Now, I use preformed, like I was saying before. And they're different sizes. I get them from JBC, get them from Priscilla. And I've when this doctor started asking for these, I just went to Priscilla and said, send me each one of your sizes. So they range from, I believe, 24, size 24 to size 30. So they come with two each. And so as I run out of a preform, I'll just order a new one. So I usually just try to eyeball it. I'll start somewhere in the middle. Here's a 28. Let's try that. Oh, shoot. I forgot about the chat. Sorry. Let me get that up. Boop, 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 boop. Chat, chat, chat. If anybody's chatting, I'm sorry. I wasn't paying attention. Having a hard time getting my... Alright. It is showing that I'm not live streaming right now. Ooh. That is not... Ooh. Yuck. I don't know what that was. Wow, that did not like me doing that. Alright, let's go back. Oh, here we go. Here it is. Hey, Jay's there. Okay. Let me pop this out. Right. Pop out chat. It is showing that I'm not live streaming right now. We're doing labial bowl class now. I'm a second year student at Government Dental College in India. Very cool. Like bro, do you have an Instagram account? I do have an Instagram account. It's just a personal one. I have one for my lab, too. Look up Tippett Orthodontic Lab. Tippett, T-I-P-P-E-T-T, Orthodontic Lab. I do have
here it
one
is.
For my...
Hey, Jay's there. Okay.
Ortho Lab account. And I have a personal one called Cade Tippett, T-I-P-P-E-T-T. We have seen this. Can't hear what you say. Hopefully, y'all can hear me now.
Maybe we
can't hear your voice clearly.
All
right.
At Government
I'm going to turn it up. So be careful, everyone.
Bro, do you have an Instagram account?
Okay.
I do have an Instagram account.
Hopefully, that's louder.
It's just a personal one. I have one for my lab, too. Look up... Tippett Orthodontic Lab.
Ecuador.
Tippett,
very
T-I-P-P-E-T-T,
cool.
T-I-P-P-E-T-T Orthodontic Lab. I do have...
What's your kid doing now?
Here it
what
is
class?
For
okay, my
hey,
kid was
Jay's
doing
there.
The acrylic
okay.
class.
Ortho Lab account. I have a personal one called Cade
Tippett.
T-I-P-P-E-T-T.
He was doing his very first acrylic streaming class.
We have
class.
Seen this.
Can't that
hear
was,
what you say. I'm hopefully...
That was really fun. I enjoyed that.
Clearly.
Watching him do that. I just let him have fun. And there were some other technicians there, and they were showing him all their techniques, because there's so many ways to do...
It's just a personal one. I have one from my lab, too.
So many ways to do
Tippett
the acrylic
lab.
Ecuador.
That,
Tippett, you know,
cool.
you just pick which one matches you the best.
Kid,
and that way,
class,
you know, okay, my
hey,
kid was doing the acrylic class. It matches your style. Some people like to sprinkle really fast
because
they don't like doing the acrylic part, so they sprinkle real fast, but they don't mind doing the trimming part, so they spend more time trimming when they sprinkle fast. Some people like sprinkling,
and
they don't like doing the trimming, so they sprinkle almost exactly to where they just waste a minimal amount of trimming. So I'll hopefully produce a video in the future on how to do that. or why you would choose one or the other.
And that way,
that's what's great about the conference is you can get ideas from other people.
Like to sprinkle really fast.
I pick up ideas every year from there.
They sprinkle real fast, but I don't mind doing the trimming part. So they spend more time trimming when they sprinkle fast. Some people like sprinkling.
I just let them have fun. They don't like doing it. Hopefully you can hear my voice now. I can try to talk more directly into the mic.
Trimming. So I'll hopefully produce a video in the future on how to do that.
Pretty much what I'm doing here,
and that way, that's what's great about the conference,
is I'm trying to match up,
get ideas from other people,
like to sprinkle really fast. I pick up
ideas every year from there. Sprinkle real fast, but I don't mind doing the trimming part. So they spend more time trimming.
Every mouth is different. So I'm trying to. This looks like it's going to be a little too long. I'm just trying to get a trial mic fit in here. Usually, I don't know if you can see this or not. Usually there's a round end and a square end.
As I'm trying to match up,
get ideas from other people. Let me see if I can get a better angle of this. Every mouth is getting a round end and a square end.
This looks like
and so the round end goes toward the gum line. I'm trying to get the square end goes toward the incisal edge.
Usually, I don't know if you can see this or not.
I think usually there's a close. This is the hard part is trying to, because you don't want to spend all your time bending this, and then at the end you figure out, oh man, I could have gone a size bigger or smaller. I think that might work. All right, so that was size 28. Just got to remember that.
Every mouth is
getting a round end and a square end.
This looks like
and so the round end goes toward the gum line.
Trying to get the square end.
You have crazy delay. Oh, I know. Like delay on my voice, Steve, or
this is the hard part is
just cause you want in audio. Like, is it echoey delay, or just?
Oh man, I could have gone a size bigger. Things aren't matching up. I think that might work.
All right, so that was size 28. Just gotta remember that.
Every mouth is getting a round end and a square end.
This looks like
and so the round end goes toward the gum line.
Trying to get the square end goes toward. You have crazy delay. Oh, I know. Like delay on my voice, Steve, or
this is the hard part is
just cause you in audio. Like, is it echoey delay, or just?
Oh man, I could have gone a size bigger.
Things aren't matching up.
I think that might work. All right, so that was size 28. Just gotta remember that.
Trying to get a nice shot of all three of these. So I kind of have this in a
crazy delay. Oh, I know.
And for those. You know, I'll
like delay on my
get back
voice
into getting my guests line up, lined up and stuff for this,
like, is it
for these live streams next week. I'm still, man, that conference took it out of me.
So that was size 28. Just
trying to get a nice shot of all three of these. So I kind of have this in a
delay.
Three channels at once, like those, my three videos. Like, is that what you're talking about,
back
Steve?
Into getting my guests line up,
lined up and stuff for
audio.
This,
like, is it
for these live streams.
Okay,
so you see,
next
I
week
need to round it down, need to drop that down a little bit more.
Took it out of me.
I'll just take my three prong, just kind of tease it on down.
A nice shot of all three of these. So I kind of have this.
Turn off something. Three voices at once.
My three videos.
Like, is that what you're talking about, Steve?
Getting my guests line up.
Three voices at once. All right. Let me turn off something.
Like, is it echo these live streams?
Okay. So you see,
next week
need to round it down. Need to drop that down a little bit more.
Took it out of me.
I'll just take my three prong. Just kind of. All right. I'm gonna switch cameras.
A nice shot. I kind of have this in a...
I might have a video playing in the background.
Turn off something.
Three. All right. Sorry. Figured it out. I had a YouTube video playing in the background. So it should be better now. So this part's just, you know, just basic wire bending. You want to touch every single tooth. You want it right on that cingulum. You want those pads as centered in that tooth as possible. So what the doctor's going to do, and these are light cure pads. They got holes in them. There's other pads that are solid. And I use these for lingual retainer pads. They're kind of like the back of a bracket. So as you can see, they're solid. So I can solder to the back of them. So when I need to custom make one of these, I use these pads. And next time I need to make one of these, I'll make a video. Again, there are tons of ways to do these. I'm sure there's plenty of videos out there. I'm sure Steve and Jay probably have a lot nicer videos than what I got. All right, I'm getting the thumbs up from Steve Zara. Long time no talk, man. We'll have to call each other soon. Plan the next one. Ah, camera keeps going to sleep. Sorry. I don't have it. Took the SD card out of it. And when there's no SD card in it, it thinks it's in the store. And so it just goes into advertising mode. So again, I'm just adapting. I like to look at it this way, at this angle, so that I can see the height of it. And then I like to look at it from this angle, so I can see to make sure it's all touching the teeth. So I always check two angles on here. And that's where these model holders come in handy, is I can tilt this and keep it in one direction. I can actually tilt it even more if I want to. But it looks like this is working good. So looking at this, it looks like I need to bring this pad down at a better angle. So I'm going to kind of eyeball this. Yeah, Steve, I was doing those live streams at the conference, and I went back to watch him, and I've, you know, it never goes perfect, but, you know, it was good enough for people to get their CE credits, but there's some changes I'd like to make, and I think I'm going to start recording all four channels. I just need the software, so I can record all four channels and get all the audio from that. And then mix it later, because I was pulling audio, kind of like what happened just now. Oh, good, camera angles. Thanks, Greg. This one is a little blurry. I'll try to tap on it, see if I can get it a little better. Aha! Ooh, that looks good. Yeah. All right, so this is a little in between. That was a 28. I kind of want to try a 29, but this is so close that I don't know if I want to try go through the effort of trying a 29. But let's just see if I can get one on there. So this is 28. Again, the round edge of the pad goes toward the gum line. The straight edge. Getting the camera there. The straight edge goes toward the incisal edge. And I'll try to get it right in the middle. Sometimes when you struggle with these preformed and it seems like it's taking you forever to bend them, you might just have the wrong size. And I hate to say it, but sometimes you got to bend one all the way like I just did. And figure out how it's laying on the teeth, and then realize you got to go up a size or down a size. But always be prepared to custom make your own. So hopefully you can see I'm starting to get a gap. I'm liking how this is looking. But if I turn the angle around, I can see this. And see how it's flaring up? I gotta round that thing down. I try to get the camera angles from all sides because my big, fat, hairy hands get in the way, especially working with this small stuff. There we go. Getting closer. All right, so from what I can tell, I need to torque this. See, it's flared up. I need to torque this down this way and this way. Dadgum camera keep going to sleep on me. I'm going to go find an SD card and shove in there. Now, from this angle, it looks good, right? But if I turn it around where you can see it from the top, you can see there's a big, huge... I'm not touching any of the teeth. So that tells me I need to round it more. See, just that rounding just a little bit made a huge difference. Now, I'm still not touching this tooth, so I'm just going to round right here. And again, I've heard this said before, you know. They say when you're trying to slightly bend, if you see it bend, you've bent it too much. So, if anybody's taking my wire bending 101, I kind of go over that a little bit. You know, obviously making rod angles, you want to see it bend, but when you're just, usually three prongs are adjusting pliers, kind of what I'm doing here, just doing slight adjusting. You don't want to really bend with them. There we go. So if I get that to touch all these teeth, it's not touching this tooth, and it's not touching that tooth. So I need to place a bend there. Now I'm doing this without a marker, because I can't find my marker. It's somewhere around. I've set it somewhere. There we go. I think we are good. I'm touching every tooth. I've got the right height on everything. I like the way that looks. Should be comfortable for the patient. And so I'm going to wax this down before anything bad happens to it. Let's see if I can find my waxer here. Let me adjust this just a little bit. Sorry, I'm trying to find my camera angles. Okay, that's that one. That's this one. All right, let me see if I can. I move it, and then I can't find it again. Okay, so now I'm going to wax this down, and then we're going to make the matrix transfer tray. And I make mine out of lab putty. And I'm going to show that process to you. Now, Jay Tyler has a great trick if you're soldering these. And Jay, you might have to elaborate if you're watching still. He uses heat shield, which will hold these on here until you're done soldering. Was it soldering, Jay? Are you still here? I think he was soldering one of these. So be sure and look up his video. Subscribe to him and Steve if y'all haven't, and that way y'all can get caught up. I'm just heating it, making little adjustments. It shifted on me. So I got them in the middle. All right, that's the way I like it. So that was actually 29. And I put my 28 back in my box here. All right, let me zoom out just a bit. The wrong way. So I use Siliform. This is by Jericho. Extra hard 90 silicone putty. I like the 90. I like the hardness of it. It's easy to cut with a knife. And it's a two-part activator and base. So it's oh, it's a hold down for the delivery matrix. Gotcha. Yeah, kind of what I'm doing here. Now, I have a steamer, and many of you don't have a steamer. I have a steamer that'll take this wax right off. With Jay, if you don't have a steamer, Jay's method is great. So I don't know, but change screens. I guess I was on the wrong screen for a second there. But it's two parts, and you just pick out equal parts. Don't mix these two together, obviously. Get them about the same size. I need a little bit extra here. All right. That's about the right size. Let me put these back. I want to say this was like $127 for this. This is going to last me forever. So to me, it was well worth the money. So then you get your putty together. Mix it. I usually mix it until I don't see the marble effect anymore. All right, so now it's nice and smooth, and I'm going to put this on here. Kind of take my time. I try to push it in so it captures all the wire. Hey, Jay, you're good now. I see the cowboy hat. Did y'all see the post where Chris got a cowboy hat from Priscilla? That was awesome. I don't even own a cowboy hat. I live in Texas. Lived here all my life. I'm going to let that set up for a second. I'm going to turn on my steamer. So that's setting up. you only need to give it like a couple minutes and it gets real hard. The knife I like to use is this knife. I get it from JBC and Company. It's got an amazing blade on it. Let's see if I can get... We call it the Freddy Krueger knife. It's great for opening boxes and stuff for... for opening boxes for shipping. Because it just gets right in there. But then I love using it for this. And you can resharpen the blade. And you can buy replacement blades. And just unscrew it. Take it out. For those that do study models, check out her. She takes blades like this. And she heats it and curls the tip. Where you can get in this vestibular area. Right here. I don't know if anybody still does study models or not. But... I mean, it's a great... I used to use this all the time. And you just change the blade out when it gets rusty or old or whatever. Let's see if I can change my camera angle here. Okay. So it looks like it's almost done. I want to give it a few more minutes, but you can see it's really hard. Can you hear that? I mean, it is really hard. Thing keeps going to sleep on me. Yeah, so I think it's set up. What was that, a couple minutes? That wasn't long at all. All right. So try not to break teeth off, obviously. So let me switch cameras here. There we go. So that thing got captured right into the matrix. So it pretty much took the red pill. Didn't you? No? No? Nobody? Anybody there? Hello? Alright. Alright, so let me clean this up in case it gets in my way. I like the sticky wax, it just pops off. Now, what we're doing is we're creating something where the doctor can place it in the patient's mouth, bond the two ends, and then peel this thing right off. And it's a transfer tray, pretty much. So I'm going to cut about at the gum line. See if I can get y'all to see this. See how this just cuts so cleanly? I'm going to do the gum line here, too. I don't want to extend it down into the gums tissue area too much. Now, I'm going to, before I pull this out, I'm going to go ahead and cut a window for these. This is my favorite part, if you can't tell. See how handy this knife is. There we go. I'm gonna put a little bevel here to let that doctor have a little bit of room to work. In fact, I may take some of this thickness out. Now, the reason I'm using this is I don't have a BioStar machine. I just started my lab. I haven't been able to afford one yet. So otherwise, I would do the suck down, do the soft, and then the hard, suck down, and then cut it out that way. But until then, man, I haven't heard complaints about this at all from this doctor. So I'm taking this slow so you're gonna see it, but y'all can see it's pretty easy to deal with. Again, this is not the prettiest. Usually, I like to make that a little taller, but. Cut off too much. Hey, if you mess up, You can just make it again. No big deal. So now you can see, they'll take this, I'll send it to them like this. Again, I'm waiting for the steamer to charge up. And then I'll steam clean this off. So you can see, I'll send it to them like this. They'll just take it off and then place it back in. They'll prep the linguals of the canines and they'll place it back on here. They'll put glue on the pads on here, press it onto here, smooth out the glue, and then light cure it. Boom, you're ready. And then when it's ready, they just peel this off and it's sitting there. And then they can bond each tooth if they want. It's up to them. But that's why you got to make sure it's touching each tooth before you start this. And you can see where on the inside, you can see I'm touching each tooth. All right, that's it. Got any questions for me? Raculo F88. Hi, guys. Hi. It's nice to see everybody again. I'm glad to get back into this. If you haven't, I'm still going to steam clean this, so I'm not leaving totally yet. But I'm going to, if y'all haven't subscribed, I try to live stream every Wednesday at noon. Try to as best as I can. Hopefully, it's going to be I'm trying this for a year, and I'll try to answer your questions. I'll have guests on like Steve or Jay, and I'll try to get some more new blood in there for the guests. Although I think Steve and Jay and I could talk for hours and hours about Ortho Lab, just like y'all can. So make sure you subscribe and then push that little bell icon and then you'll instantly get alerted when I go live. And so you can just tune in on your phone or laptop or iPad or whatever. And then you can join the chat right then. So let me see. Yeah. I'm going to take one of these cameras with me. This one. All right. Disregard the dirty lab. So I'm going to end it. Thank you for tuning in. Hopefully you had a good time. Keep an eye out for those videos. Give me a thumbs up if you like this. If you didn't like it, do a thumbs down if you want, but please don't. But let me know in the comments what you liked, what you don't like, what you'd like to see. Any guests you'd like to hear from. If you want me to talk to Priscilla from JBC or just got a request for EZRX, so we might have some of those planned for in the future. Just again, stay tuned with Steve Zara and Jay Tyler. Subscribe to their channels if you haven't already. They're doing the same thing we're doing, trying to educate everybody and connect everybody together. I think you got Ortho Lab Tip on every Tuesday, so keep an eye out for that. And I'm live streaming every Wednesday. So until then, happy wire bending, and I will see y'all next Wednesday.